Ja todella vähän jutsuta kiljaa toimintaisia. Voidaan jätiä noin yhdessä kyllä
you I catch my breath to explain to you what in the hell I was just doing. So I know you're sitting there wondering, like, is she okay? Is she mentally unstable, emotionally unstable, physically ill? What's going on? The answer is yes. Just kidding. Emotionally unstable, Kundalini awakening, emotionally unstable. I think they're synonymous sometimes, but not to worry. This whole process is about trust. So what was it that I was just doing? I was just having what is called a Kundalini Kriya. It is manifestations of a Kundalini awakening, which I popped off into full-blown Kundalini awakening about 15 months ago, November 3rd last year. So what is a Kriya? When the ego identity unravels long enough through quiet states of mind, such as meditation, any sort of meditation moment that you have in your life, that could be while you're drawing, while you're listening to music, while you're dancing, while you're doing yoga. Most people think that meditation is only for people who sit down and get into a meditative pose. However, there are many ways to reach quiet state of mind. Mine happened while writing a book that had to do with a lady whose emotional repression led her to have a physical mutation. She kind of busted out of her skin, she became this mutant creature. And the rest of the book is about her healing journey. In the book, I deeply explored the elements of the destroyer, the things in our life that cause us to have fear, competition, jealousy, pain, heartache, and dysfunctions in our life, and how a person goes from that to the higher transcendent qualities of understanding, peace, love, forgiveness, and connection and purpose in life. While exploring that and going deeply into the characters and giving my mind permission to feel all of the emotions and all of the things attributing to each character, what happened is my brain began to rewire towards a state of unity consciousness instead of duality thinking, which essentially is coming to realize that your life, for me this is what it was like, realizing that your life is like pieces of a puzzle. And you look back and you see that there was a reason for every single thing that happened to you. And that you were being molded like a piece of human clay. When you throw that trust upon something other than the ego identity, who this world told you you were, your first name, your last name, your job, your family, your relationships, your talents, your skills, who you were, what you are, before the world told you what you were, is what happens when you go into a meditative state of mind. When that happens, the brain starts to rewire towards unity, so it no longer sees itself so much as a separate mechanism. Once that happens, the whole body structure, the cells, the DNA that was used to comprise the unit that was before in a judgment state of mind that kept it together in a firm structure of who you think you are, begins to unravel. Kundalini awakens from the base of the spine, and it's a purging energy. So it runs through the chakras. So what you saw me doing upside down there was energy running from the sacral chakra to the solar plexus, to the heart, the throat, eventually is the third eye and the crown. But what you're also seeing is like what you could envision as a tube running from the sacral chakra up through the heart, or I mean up through the throat. So with vocal kriyas, what it does is it overrides the mental structure. So what I've gathered from my experience is that we are capable of language before we are shown the structure of language, but humans already have language. So certain sounds, certain vibrations are innate, but we don't use them. So society says for me to speak like this Minnesotan girl. But I am capable beyond that, even without the learned structure. So also what tones and vibrations do is send out, this is what I'm gathering. A Kundalini awakening is fairly mysterious still, it's not studied. So this is the insights that I'm gathering through firsthand experience of having it. Anyways, certain tones send messages to the structure, to implode or be destroyed, and to basically resurrect. So this is the common rebirth in spiritual people that we talk about, that they have a death and an awakening or a rebirth. So my vocal kriyas came on fairly powerful, and my body poised itself in a very it poised itself in a very strong, very grounded, very fierce way. And that was, and what I think that was, sending messages to the body to break down the previous molecular structure of Angela. And it was giving the command to destroy the old self. People get really scared when you start talking about destroy and destruction. But in order to rebirth something, you know, I like to think of a fire burning through, and at first we think it's devastating. And then this beautiful, lush, amazing forest grows simply from the divine. Not from anything that we did, we just got out of the way. So vocal and physical kriyas are getting out of the way of the higher self. And it doesn't matter what you call it, what name you give it. I have no name for it other than higher self or universe or kundalini or divine presence. And you put that trust, that faith into that growing thing, and it changes you to, it begins to change you to the next level of human evolution. So it's common to know that you move from a newborn to a toddler to an adolescent to an adult. And it is not commonly known that there is a stage after adulthood in which we have the opportunity to unify with our higher self and begin to see ourselves as very connected. As the old molecular structure begins to implode and the kundalini energy starts to rise up, it moves the body in different ways. And yes, it is moving without the mental construct. So that means I have not given a command, left arm move, right arm move. You go into this state of mind. A lot of times what the first kriya that people will get is either a jerking in their stomach, like this, that goes all the way up the spine, or they'll, one of my first one was a head shaking back and forth like this. Oh, very fast. That was one of the first ones they had, and then it went through a lot of stuff. It went into emotional kriyas, which you did see some of that there with this screaming, the kind of, it's kind of pushing something out. I did go through dry heaving and coughing that moved through the chakra system. What I believe that's doing is, like, if you think of somebody else in describing a kundalini awakening, describe it as a mop being wrung out. So that old structure implodes. It goes, you're not this identity. That's my puppy. Okay, that's good. Okay, so the old identity implodes. Stop it. Oh, we're gonna have to call it quits here. Back later. Stop, baby.